Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video we are going to discuss about chapter 2 acid bases and salts of class 10th. So I will explain indicators, acid and bases with the few experiments. So let's start with me. I am taking this experiment to explain about the acid and base and indicators, that how indicator is working on the acid and basic solution. I took these two solutions in two test tubes and marked A and B on that one. And I took these two red and blue litmus paper. First of all, I am going to dip this blue litmus paper in A test tube. There is no changes in this blue litmus paper. Now I am taking the red litmus paper and going to dip in this A test tube. You can observe that the red litmus paper going to change into blue litmus paper. Now I am taking test tube B and going to dip this blue litmus paper in this test tube. You can observe that the blue litmus paper is converting into red litmus paper. So can you identify that which one is the acid and which one is the base? Means in A and B test tube, which solution is containing? A is converting red litmus paper into blue litmus paper, so it is a basic solution. In B test tube, blue litmus paper is converting into red litmus paper, so this is an acidic solution. So we can know through this experiment that A test tube is containing basic solution and B test tube is containing acidic solution. And this litmus paper is working as an indicator. So now we will study what is an indicator. So indicators are the substances which tell us about the acid and base when these substances come in the contact with acid and base. So that is known as the indicators. These substances means the indicators divided into two parts, natural indicators and the synthetic indicators. Natural indicators which we are getting from the nature and synthetic indicators which is made by the chemicals. Natural, you can see examples, litmus solution, turmeric solution, these are the natural indicators. Litmus solution which we are getting from the lichen plant. And the synthetic litmus paper which we are making from the litmus solution, that is the synthetic indicators, and methyl orange, phenolphthalein, these are also the synthetic indicators. Now we will discuss about the acid and base. So what is the difference between acid and base? Acid sour in taste and the base are bitter in taste. Acid can change the blue litmus into red litmus. You can learn the trick BAR, bar. Blue litmus, acid convert into red litmus. Like that, bases convert the red litmus into blue, RBB. Red convert by base into blue. So you can learn RBB. Now according to Arrhenius theory, Arrhenius theory means the substances when we dissolve in water, if they are giving hydrogen ion, H plus ion, that is known as the acids, and if they are giving OH minus ion by dissolving in water, that is known as the bases. So now I will tell you that suppose we are having two solutions, acidic solution and basic solution. So what happens when it comes in the contact with the litmus solution? The blue litmus convert into red, that is acidic. The blue red litmus convert into blue, that is basic solution. Suppose they are coming in the contact with phenolphthalein. So in acidic solution, phenolphthalein becomes colorless, and in basic solution, phenolphthalein convert into pink color. Methyl orange, when come in contact with acid and base, the acidic solution convert red methyl orange into red, and the basic convert methyl orange into yellow. Now we will discuss about the properties of acid and bases. So first of all, I am taking reaction with metals. You can see that when metal react with acid, it forms salt and hydrogen gas. Suppose metal is Zn, reacting with any acid, suppose H2SO4, and forming salt. that is ZnSO4 plus H2. Now metal react with base, it will form salt and hydrogen gas. Suppose I am taking metal Zn, base is NaOH and it is forming salt which is complex Na2ZnO2 plus H2. So when acid and base react with metals, they are forming hydrogen gas. How we can know that the released gas is hydrogen? We can bring a lighted candle nearby the hydrogen gas, then it will burn with a pop sound. So you can know that this is the hydrogen gas. Reaction with metal oxide and non-metal oxides. When metal oxide or reacting with acid, it will form the salt and water. Same non-metal oxide also reacting with base and forming salt and water. Suppose metal oxide is CuO reacting with HCl and forming CuCl2 and water. Non-metal oxide, suppose CO2 reacting with CaOH2, that is in base, and forming CaCO3 plus water. So during this reaction, water is forming. Now metal oxides are basic in nature and the non-metal oxides are acidic nature. How you will know? Suppose HCl is acid, so acid react with base, so that is the metal oxide. So metal oxide is basic in nature. CaOH2, this is the base, it is reacting with CO2, non-metal oxide, which is working like an acid. So non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Now the third one is the neutralization reaction. Neutralization reaction means when acid and base react together, they are forming the salt and water. Suppose acid, I am taking HCl, it is reacting with base NaOH and it is forming salt NaCl plus water. So why we are saying neutralization? Because acid neutralize the base properties and base neutralize the acidic properties. Both are neutralizing the properties of acid and base. So this is known as the neutralization reaction. Now fourth one is the acid react with metal carbonate and hydrogen carbonate. It is reacting when metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate reacting with acid, it will form salt, water and carbon dioxide. I am taking metal carbonate Na2CO3 reacting with acid HCl, it is forming NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. So in this process, salt, water and CO2 is forming. The number of H plus ions per unit volume is known as the concentration of acids and bases. When we are adding more water in these solutions, it will termed as the dilution process. So dilution decreases the H plus ions in the per unit volume. So concentrated solution and dilute solution means concentrated more H plus ions, dilute means less H plus ions.